Hi, I'm Steve.
And I'm Kim.
And in this little video, we're going to be discussing the topic and the emotion of anger.
Anger can be a habitual crutch that some people reach for every time they feel weak or they feel vulnerable. Because anger actually has the ability very quickly to make us feel powerful and make us feel better when we're in this situation. So in this way, anger can actually become quite addictive.
Anger might make you feel guilty and ashamed afterwards, but you won't learn to regulate that until you realize that anger can give you a real buzz. It can make you feel really powerful. It's an addictive thing.
So what is anger good for?
So why do we feel anger? It helps us see how we want to be treated and helps us recognize perhaps when we're being exploited or manipulated.
You can't learn what your anger is trying to teach you if you let it control you in the heat of the moment.
We really recommend with anger that you learn to start to recognize all of the signs in your body when you're starting to become angry and when it's starting to overcome you. These may be you feeling blood rushing into your arms, you may feel your heart rate increasing, you may feel that you're starting to feel like you're breaking into a sweat, or that your voice is starting to rise. The sooner that you learn to recognize these signs and realize that you need to regulate this emotion and perhaps pull yourself out of this situation to think about what's happened later on when you've calmed down and not in the heat of the moment, is a skill very worth learning. Hotheads don't do well in life.
It's very difficult to make the right decision in the heat of the moment.
I was taught by a lot of people, and I even had it on my blog for a while, that a good thing to do when you were angry was to chop wood or box or play tennis or throw telephone books at the bed or swing your arms around and get the anger out of your system. But what I discovered is that this is actually not true. There's a lot of research to show that you're actually much better to do something soothing and calming when you're angry, to help you calm down and forget about your anger rather than things that arouse it and work you up even more. Some things that I really enjoy doing when I'm angry and help me calm down is going for a long walk, particularly under big trees that I find beautiful. If I'm not in a situation where I can go on one of my favorite walks, I have a book of trees that I look at and think about identifying them in my walks in nature. I also have some recordings of rain sounds that I listen to and I really enjoy and find very soothing.
I like to spend some time in my garden and dig up a few weeds or just have a look at all the beautiful flowers and all of the insects that are enjoying my garden too.
Now it's very important when you get angry that you don't listen to that voice that's going on inside of your head. That voice is just about always going to give you bad advice. Instead, what we recommend is that you make a note of what it is that's made you angry in the first place. You tell the person that you're angry with that you're angry and that you need some time to cool down. And then you make a decision that you won't do anything about this or even think about it again until you've calmed down. Now, this may actually take a couple of days.
After you've written down what has troubled you, it gives you the space then to enjoy the things that are going to soothe you.
This is not the same as repressing or ignoring your anger. That's not what we're recommending here at all. Learning to recognize the symptoms of your own anger and when you're becoming angry and aroused is actually honoring your own anger and your own feelings and recognizing the power of them. Making a note of what it is that upset you and where perhaps a boundary has been crossed with you is actually a very wise thing to do, because we really do recommend that later you give this your full thought and attention, but only after you've completely calmed down and you're ready to think about it rationally.
Giving yourself that time to settle down gives you the chance to make the right decision.
As long as you're still thinking thoughts of getting even or of any kind of revenge or of yourself as a victim, there's a really good chance that you haven't calmed down yet. It's amazing how differently we can see the same situation a couple of days later, when we may realize that that person didn't really mean to throw the ball at our head. They were actually just looking at us and not paying attention to what they were doing.
If you've given yourself that time, you probably don't feel like being angry with that person anymore anyway.
But you probably will need to do some real work on strengthening that boundary that's been crossed. And we give a lot of information on this in the Love Safety Net workbook and in our ebooks. Another aspect of anger that isn't talked about much is that people can use anger, and any emotion for that matter, as a tool to manipulate their partner. And this, if done repeatedly, can really build a rift between partners and create a lot of resentment and make yourself very unattractive. This is a very common thing to do, however, and so I'll give you a little bit of an idea of what it looks like. Your partner's done something that's upset you, but rather than self-soothing and taking care of your own emotions yourself and taking responsibility for you taking yourself out of the situation and calming down, instead, you stay angry and stew on it and insist that your partner does something to make you feel better.
This will only breed resentment and won't bring you closer to your partner at all. Nobody likes to feel that they're being manipulated by somebody else's emotions. Not only is it manipulation, it rarely works.
The voice in your head that talks to you when you're angry may tell you that you need to stay angry at your partner and demand that they make it up to you, or that you've in fact been some kind of a pushover or let them get away with it. Well, nothing could actually be further from the truth. There's much more important ways to limit abuse and to protect your own boundaries than on insisting that somebody make you feel better. We deal with these in more depth in Back from the Looking Glass and the Love Safety Net workbook. You'll actually become stronger as you learn to stop letting your partner push your buttons and be in control of your own happiness and be able to self-soothe and calm down by yourself.
We really hope you found this video helpful, and thanks for taking part in the anger section of the Love Safety Net Love Boat Cruise.
There's a whole lot more movies like this that you can visit on our site, which is thelovesafetynet.com.